It's good to be here today, you know. For me, it's good to be here today. I'm going to tell you a wee bit about Inverclyde Recovery Cafe. I came here in 2004, about 10 years ago. He's making me a visa this year. Came down here, right? I was unwanted, I was unloved, and I was unwashed. I was 6.5 stone. I was jaundiced, had sepsis, and then hepatitis C. And nowhere to go. I'm not going to have a big drink of all. Right? What you need was I drank too often, I drank too much, I drank too long. I came to Canary to a wee place up the road. It was a Salvation Army, it was called Fister House. Local to the moor. That's sadly not there now. When I came down here, I had a bin bag, a big razor, and a pair of boxer shorts, and that was me. And I'd resigned myself to the fact that, you know what, I'll die here. I've got the option of going there, because I got two fair hostels in Glasgow and the Gallagher called the World Growth Hotel. Hotel. Anyway, so I got down here, but I resigned myself. I only came here because I thought, a change of scenery. I just thought, nothing left for me. But I got better. I got a wee bit better. I managed to put the substance, the drink down itself, you know. I went to another fellowship that's nearly started the phone book. So you can work that out yourself. So I went to another fellowship, you know. I was through services and treatment providers in Inverclyde. The treatment providers, you saw preserving, you saw the job he's supposed to do. He's doing a wonderful service, you know. You go there, you get people sober, you get people clean. What's after that? There's the fellowships, there's Alcoholics Anonymous, Narcotics Anonymous. Now, they're not for everybody. We've got the cafe down here, which is for everybody. Your cafe, Inverclyde Recovery Cafe. Make no mistake, this is not about drinking drugs. Every one of us in here are recovering from something. Do you know what I mean? You can come to your cafe, we've got the website. I'll put one of these on your tables. You have a wee look, and I'll be able to tell you where, what we're about. You know, I grew up a shy man, I couldn't talk to anybody. You know, this was a living, I had a living problem. Drink was my answer, it wasn't my problem. I grew up feeling as if I'd a home in my soul. You know, see when I took a drink, it made me feel part of. That was a missing piece of the jigsaw that I felt. I don't need that now. I've got the cafe, I've got lots of people in my boots. You know, I'm not doing this myself. I think I can do this myself, I'm banging in trouble. So when I took up my drinks, I said, it felt a home in my soul. You know, and if it's fine like that, I'd be in my life. It wouldn't be here with it, but it didn't, you know, progress on, you know. It took a lot to find me. But listen, it doesn't matter. That's the past, it's history. So, you know, it's a feeling different, you know. And I said to him, through the treatment providers, fellowships, and the cafe. The cafe now, as I said, it's not for me. It was always a living problem, you know. Because even back then, I felt different. You know, the parties were on in our house. I stayed in the tenements in New England. I used to hear the music. I'm never going to drink. I'm never going to drink. They pulled it. Camber look bedspread, we didn't have two weeks in. Camber look bedspread, I'm not eating them, but in my shack, somebody passed it with crap to me. There's a Christian reason to take his drums in existence. I stopped through my mum's special brews, you know, and I drank them. No, I drank any two special brews, and I get this wee ready break for them. I'm going like that. That's Shirley Bassey's, no bad there. I'm up dancing away to Jim Reed. No, I didn't continue like that. Took everything from me. But see the day, no, I'm going to Wednesday and a Friday night. I'm going to see guys like George. I'm going to see it. There's a lot more to this, you know. It teaches you about your own website, what it's done for me. To tell you, see this shy wee boy? See, 3 weeks ago, it was in Lanzarote at an AA convention. I got up in front of 750 people with my guitar. I've never done it before. My partner was on it for me. Just get up there and be here. I took my guitar, I stood up in front of 750 people, and I sang a song. No, need to. They'll make it half. What are you? I wasn't late, but I've done it. No, it's given me the confidence. All the stuff I've done has given me the confidence to be part of the community again. That's what it's all about. That's what your cafe's hoping for. People, empty feel in isolation, empty. They drink the drugs, let's put that to the side. And there's plenty of cafe, cafe's open to empty. Families, people in addiction. Aye, there's people in addiction. I was in addiction, not in recovery. I believe we're all recovering. You should have a look at the website. George is going to tell you a wee bit. What he's done, he's in the cafe, and what he's doing in his personal life today. Thanks.
Well, I'm George. Just not going to talk too long about my past, but I'm an addict in that prison. Just a chaotic lifestyle. My family, it was nothing to do with. I had a good upbringing, that I just, for me, taking drugs, I could be somebody else, and that's because I was like there with myself, I was shy, you know what I mean? But drugs gave me that wee bit of power to talk and be socialising, you know what I mean? But 15 years later, I'm here now, going to the cafe, and I said I was isolating myself, I was locked myself in the house, just, I don't know what I'm scared of, but I'm scared of the unknown, you know what I mean? But coming to the cafe, gained new friends, I've got a social life now. I've done a play, that was a big thing for me in the Beacon Centre. Basically, after we've done a play in here, it's gave me confidence to speak what I'm doing right now. It's a big thing for me still, but I'm here and I'm doing it, you know what I mean? I feel confident within myself, I'm happy. I'm the crew I'm in now, I'm comfortable within myself, you know what I mean? I go to college, I'm doing health and social care. Enjoy that as well. I've got new, got other friends in there as well. I'm a facilitator for Smart Recovery. I don't know if anyone's heard that, but we facilitate that now. We've seen my clients only, there's six of us in the monthly that can facilitate that, which is going to kick off. So I'm happy that I can bring something to the community and help people myself. It's going through that road, you know what I mean? I'd just like to thank the cafe and everybody that's in it, and thanks for being us out today.
Anybody got any questions?
And then
the recovery
cafe.
Do you want to
be different on what times at the start? We meet alternative Wednesdays and Fridays from 5 o'clock to 8 o'clock p.m. That's down at Methodist Church in Argyle Street.
For the next 13 weeks, incorporated into the cafe night. Tai Chi classes. In that class, there's going to be members of the cafe, whoever wants, they're going to be trained to train other people in Tai Chi and take that into the community. The cafe's all about putting back into the community. Whatever we take in, it's going back out to you, it's going back out to everybody. All your participants. Is that a new PC word? I used to call myself a service abuser. Then it was a client. You can't say that. Participants of a... You know what I'm talking about. But we're here for them to check us out and sign up and join the website. Post your comments, whatever. Join in, put a new topic on the forum. Thanks for listening to you.
Can I just say thanks again? It is quite hard to come up and stand here and tell people your experiences and your journey as well. So thank you very much, and that's all of us.